Greetings, Cauldron of Weird fans. Welcome back. It's time for another solo reaction featuring me. I'm throwing this one up. I'm literally just getting home from work, like 5 minutes ago, and I'm immediately doing a reaction for you people. You're welcome. Eskimo Cowboy dropped another song. This song is called Hate Slash Love. Yeah, I'm just going to jump on into this because I love Eskimo Cowboy and I want to hear this. I saw it was getting premiered. It premiered like 9 hours ago, like literally right as I had to leave for work. So, you know, I'm just getting to it now. So, let's just jump on into it. Eskimo Cowboy, Hate Slash Love. 1, 2, 3, go. Interesting, a very serious video. Oh my god, he's dead. Oh, dude. I love this. Am I gonna have to censor something in this video? Get you a band that can do both, damn it. I love Eskimo Cowboy so much. So here's the thing. This is a fantastic song from them. Are they going for more radio play? Because that's kind of what it sounds like to me. And with the overwhelming success of Hypa Hypa, I mean, that has put them more on the map in the mainstream in terms of rock, just because you had so many people reacting to them and so many people putting them out there for more people to find. So I think this was a great way. I think this is fucking brilliant, like marketing from them. They put out something ridiculous, something crazy that people were going to eat up and, you know, just go crazy for on the internet. and which is kind of their MO for over the years. And then you go and you put out this serious song that could absolutely get a ton of radio play with the right censorship, especially here in America, but not the point. Yeah. That was some brilliant marketing on their part.
This is big brain time.
I honestly hope they do get the coverage they deserve over here, because frankly, I want to see them and I've never seen them, and I'm tired of that being the case that I haven't seen them. So why does my mustache look so derpy over here? What the fuck is going on? My mustache looks weird. Anyway, no, this was good. This was really good. I really like this. It's got just catchy enough of a chorus that I think you could have people shouting along with it in their car, or, you know, this would be like a great song for like one of those Red State Rock festivals, like Sonic Temple here, or, fucking Welcome to Rockville in Florida, or any of these rock festivals you got here in the States. But I think this would be great for that. This would be a great song for that. I mean, yeah, I like it. I really like it. I'll give the song a 10. It's a straight 10 for me. Not to mention, and just besides just the marketing aspect of it, I mean, that is the type of song that's going to get you a ton of play and people checking out the rest of your catalog. I just hope it doesn't backfire on them when they see songs like Muffin Perperker, you know. You get what I mean. The video. Video was okay. I mean, it wasn't my favorite video. Especially not from them. I'll give the video an 8 because it was good. I mean, it kept your attention. But it was pretty, like, you know, run of the mill rock video. Had the band playing. Had a sexy girl. I mean, pretty run of the mill. I liked it. 8. But the song's 10. Song absolutely gets 10. And with that said, that's going to be the end of this video. A little shorter, because it's just me. I've got to go apparently trim my facial hair, because it looks fucking terrible.
I don't even hear what you're saying right now, because your face is driving me.
Okay. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Just search Cauldron of Weird, and you'll be able to find us. It's the, you know, the cauldron. That's the logo. Just find it. You can check out me on Twitch at twitch.tv/cauldronofweird. You can check out our sponsor there, Eargasm Earplugs. Big fan of them. Thank you for continuing to stick by us. Check out our merch store if you want to support the channel directly. But just make sure you subscribe and ring the bell. We'll see y'all in the next one. I'll be the same.